Oh, is that disappointment?
Is that?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right, then we can.
Oh, well, let's hear one of your songs then.
That was a big confrontation, wasn't it? That's fair enough, I suppose. As far as the Brits are concerned,
yes.
Is it true that you said to someone that there was a threat made to you, or veiled threats to you, that not playing live at the Brits might hinder your career? Is that true?
Yeah. Twice in 2 years, actually.
What actually happened then?
The first year, we didn't particularly want to play, and they said, well, this could harm your career, and I'd like to say to the person, whoever you are...
Don't swear.
Ham. gutted. And the second year, which was the one just gone, we said that we'd play outside for the people on the streets.
Yeah.
And they said, oh, you can't do that. Oh, no, you can't do that, you see, because that would be taken away from the vibe of the show. So we said, OK, we won't do it then, without swearing. That's what I'll say.
Okay,
we won't do it. And then they said, oh, well, they're just trying to sustain their street credibility.
Do you think the Brits are a sham?
I think every time you've presented it, it's been terrible.
Do you think the awards themselves are a sham?
I think that any... I'll just get into my little...
All right,
you
know,
any award that's presented by the kids on the streets, God bless you all, is important. Anyone that's presented by people in ponytails and suits, culprit, you know, yeah. We don't really particularly interested in that. But the reason we went was because if we didn't go, it would be... We had to be there to... Well, basically, to swear on TV.
Right. And eventually they played that version where you did.
Yes.
OK. Were you aware that the organisers of the Brits condemned Jarvis for what he did during the Jackson number?
Jarvis Cocker, I must say, this Jarvis Cocker is a star and he should be given an MBE.
Yeah!
Because for Michael Jackson to come over to this country after what's all gone on, and I think we all know what we're talking about here, to dress in a white robe, right, thinking he's the Messiah. I mean, who does he think he is? Me? Right? It's out of order. The only reason I didn't dress in a white robe is because my mother could not get the wool from the shopping centre. Next year,
it's you in a white robe.
Next year, we've got the paper mache cross on that. Yes, it's all there.
Would you go next year?
Pardon?
Would you go next year?
I probably won't get nominated next year.
No, but would you go if you were?
Are you going?
I'm not
going
to go ever again.
Well, I'm not going if you're not going. Right.
How's Liam?
Big headed.
Is it true that you said he's always wanted to be me? He always has, it's just the way he is.
Of course he's always wanted to be me.
Have you ever wanted to be him? Ever? Not once, for 1 second?
I actually did, for 1 second.
Anything to do with Patsy Kensit? No? What was the 1 second you wanted to be Liam?
It was so incidental, I can't even remember it.
All right, but it was 1 second.
It was 1 second. It came and it went.
In the second?
It's just like that.
Do you need each other professionally? Do you actually need each other?
I don't need anybody.
Really?
No. See, what I need? I need my guitar and my imagination. And people like you to plug my records, Chris.
And unfortunately, it's my guitar and you won't play it.
I know.
No.
Well, it wasn't Ed's, was it? It was Taylor.
It was Ed's. You know it was blimmin' Ed's. Now you're in the kitchen, you'll say, I know it was.
Oh, yeah. Anyway. Well, maybe.
Listen, maybe. You're going to be the one. Save me.
Yeah.
I wonder why.
I like that.
Do you?
I admire that.
Cool.
I admire that.
Now, listen. Because I'm very grateful that you come on the show today, because you flew back from abroad this afternoon. The plane was late. You got here 45 minutes after you touched down at Heathrow. Got a little treat for you. Yeah?
Cool. Yes, thank you.
Best three City goals scored this season just for you. There you go.
Today is gonna be the day that they're gonna throw it back to you. By now you should have somehow realized what you gotta do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now.
Okay. Listen, we're running massively over, but I've got to ask you two questions really quickly. First of all, a prediction for tomorrow, Man United against City. Prediction, score, please.
We are going to wipe the floor with them.
Score?
Yeah.
3-0.
OK, 3-0. And also, are you going to sponsor the shirts next year? Is that true?
Well, it was an idea that was brought to us by Man City, and it was going to happen until all the lawyers and all the rest was
involved. Is it going to happen, yes or no?
Hopefully it will. I can't say one way or the other.
All right. Now, we've got to go.
Thank you very much.
Plectrum. You may have to go off the air now. I'm the his guitar. If we're going off the air at 7 o'clock, stay tuned, because on the repeat, he might be playing this guitar. Thanks very much for watching. This has been TFI Friday on Good Friday.
Grand, 50 grand.
He may well pick the guitar up and play on it. See, if you play in 5 seconds, we won't even be on the damn air anymore.
That's all right. Well, there's no point doing it then.
Oh! Noel Gallagher, anyway, there you are. Okay. Well, from the best, we'll leave you with a fantastic bit of music. This has never been seen on television before. From your gig at Earl's Court, this is exclusive footage of Champagne Supernova. This is the four-minute version. If you tune in tonight, you'll get the full 9 minutes.
Have a rocking Easter, everybody.
I wasn't going to say that. I wasn't going to say that.